Hello everyone, and welcome to Retrolinear. Here's a comprehensive installation video for our Warneck Research EP200 amplifier kit. Be sure to watch this video thoroughly before attempting installation. Make sure your piano is unplugged from the wall and to have proper tools outlined in the video. You are attempting this installation at your own risk, and the assumption has been made you have basic hand tool knowledge and skills. For additional support, please visit our support form at www.retrolinear.net or email support@retrolinear.com. Here are the following tools required to install your Warneck Research EP200 amplifier. Safety glasses, number 2 Phillips screwdriver, slot head screwdriver, 6-in-1 screwdriver, small jeweler screwdriver with slotted head, wire stripper, small diagonal wire cutter. Let's open your Wurlitzer. Using a number 2 Phillips screwdriver, remove the 2 music rack screws. Pull the volume and vibrato knobs off. Remove the 3 key slip screws underneath the piano. Place all screws and knobs in your organization bin. The lid is now ready to lift off. Using a number 2 Phillips screwdriver, remove all screws holding the reed bar cover and place them in your organization bin. This will expose the piano's damper assembly. With all the screws removed, you can carefully remove the reed bar cover. We will now separate the damper mechanisms. Carefully hold each damper arm while pressing the screw and rubber bushing away from the small metal clip which it sits in. Be sure not to bend or break these mechanisms as they are quite delicate. Remove the center screw holding the damper brackets together. There's a small lock nut on the inside. Make sure this doesn't go missing. Place all parts in your organization bin. Separate the sustain pull mechanism from the damper assembly. Be sure not to misplace the felt washer. Using a number 2 Phillips screwdriver, remove the left and right damper brackets located on the piano's reed bar. With the brackets removed, we can now remove both dampers from the piano. Starting at the treble register, remove the 2 middle screws, then put aside both flat washers. Reinsert both screws back into the pickup. Do not fully tighten. Remove both end screws and washers. Place the reed bar shield over the pickup. Insert the screws on each end and fully tighten. Remove the middle 2 screws and replace the flat washers, and then tighten fully. This procedure prevents shifting of the pickups. Remove the 2 screws holding the next pickup section down. Place the middle section rebar shield atop the pickup. Be careful not to dislodge the pickup. Insert both screws and tighten. Remove the number 2 and number 3 screws and washers. Then replace both the number 2 and number 3 screw without the washer. Then remove the screws and washers on 1, 4, and 6. Place the base reed bar shield onto the pickup. Insert screws 1, 4, and 6. Tighten. Then replace the washers on number 2 and 3. Then tighten all screws snugly. If you purchased one of our new pickup cables, here's how to install it. Unplug the old RC cable off the original amplifier and using a number 2 Phillips head screwdriver, remove the screws holding each terminal lug to the reed bars. Note the additional ground wire. This is to be left in place. Replace the screws into the new cable as shown. This step is now complete. Well, now we install the damper assemblies. Place the guide pin of the base damper into the center bushing as shown. Fully seat the pin into the nylon bushing. Replace the damper end bracket as shown. Place the treble damper assembly onto the center pin as shown. Squeeze the two damper assemblies together. Replace the remaining end brackets as shown. Connecting the dampers. Using the clamping or needle nose pliers, place the lock nut inside the damper housing. The ground wire connects through the screw as shown. We'll now reconnect the sustain pull mechanism. Note, the felt washer sits between the metal tab on the sustain pull and the housing itself. Reseat the damper poles onto each damper mechanism. The rubber bushing seats into the damper clip. Take your time completing the step and be careful not to bend or twist the damper poles, as they are quite fragile. We shall now reinstall the rebar cover. Replace the mounting screws into the rebar face. These screws will only require a few turns at this stage. Be sure to leave sufficient vertical height to avoid damper collision with the rebar cover itself. Let's cut the volume and vibrato control wires off the original amplifier. Then we're going to cut the speaker and transformer wires as well. Cut as close as possible to the circuit board to leave working slack. Using a number 2 Phillips screwdriver, remove the 7 mounting screws. Put these screws aside as they will be reused to mount the new amp. Lift the old amp away. Using a number 2 Phillips screwdriver, let's mount your new amplifier onto the rail, reusing the original screws. Make sure your screws are tight. In the event your screws have gone missing, the correct size is 6/32 by 1/2 inch with internal tooth lock washers or SEM style screws. Using a small slotted jeweler screwdriver, we can connect the transformer, speaker, line out, volume, and vibrato controls. All wires require roughly 1/8 inch of jacketing removed for an ideal connection. Before powering on the amplifier, double check that all wires are properly connected to the respective locations, especially the transformer. Also, visually check to make sure there are no individual strands of wire that are jumping from one location to another. If possible, tinning the wire is advised, however not necessary. After the connections are made, dress the wires as shown. Close up your piano, plug in, and enjoy. Thank you for watching this instructional video from Retrolinear, and have a great day.